Yeah, so Alec, just before he was turning 24, was feeling like he was getting sick. They diagnosed him on the spot with type 1 diabetes.
I remember him crying initially. Like he was really strong, but then he kind of broke down and he realized, you know, being a diabetic, he had to completely change.
You know, with him being 24, an active young man, I thought, oh, how is he ever gonna manage this? He's gonna have to change his lifestyle. He's gonna have to change, you know, basically everything, his eating habits. But he did well. He adjusted really well. I was surprised.
Walk in the house, and this is my crib.
He was gonna have a steady income. He was gonna be able to afford, you know, living on his own. Alec was an amazing person. He was a jokester. He was always pulling pranks on somebody or doing something goofy to make you laugh or smile.
I think Alec was very determined to do right by my parents and show them that they've raised a young man, a hardworking man that could take care of himself.
He turned 26, so he was no longer eligible to be under my insurance policy. When he went to the pharmacy the first time to pick up his insulin, without my coverage, his bill was $1,300. He didn't have $1,300 in the bank, so he left the pharmacy without his insulin and started rationing what little bit of insulin he had left, hoping to stretch it out to payday. He didn't tell any of us that he was doing this. I think he was enjoying his freedom of living on his own for the first time. So I think that's why he didn't ask for help. I don't think he knew that not taking the required amount of insulin would lead to death. It was absolutely horrifying.
I just miss my son. I think we'd all would do anything to get our son back, our brother back.
That week and after that moment, I mean, it changed us all forever.
It still really sometimes doesn't feel real. Feels like maybe Alec is just on vacation. And then there's moments where I wake up and I'm like, my son is gone. I'm not gonna see him anymore.
So this is the memorial garden that we created in honor of Alec. And we will keep fighting in his honor and his memory.
People hadn't really been talking about it. Type 1 diabetics not being able to afford their insulin. They've been keeping it kind of private.
Yep.
I was shocked to hear all the people that had reached out to me through social media saying, hey, my brother died the same way, or my son died the same way, my friend died the same way. And I knew that it was an issue that needed to be addressed. Alec's story has been shared all over the world.
This story is generating quite a conversation on the 11 Alive Facebook page right now. Alec's story has been reaching more than 200,000 people on Facebook with hundreds of comments. And the common themes we're seeing, outrage and people wanting something done about this.
I don't want what happened to Alec Smith to happen to my son.
My son Alec Smith was one of those diabetics who died because he did not have enough insulin.
He died because he could not afford to live. His insulin was too expensive. Alec's body was found 3 days prior to payday. Rationing is not uncommon among the diabetic community. Diabetics are starving themselves, working 2 and 3 jobs, cashing in on their retirements, dropping out of college, filing bankruptcy, maxing out credit cards, buying expired insulin from the black market. We will not go away. We will not stop sharing our stories. We will not stop.
Hey, hey! Ho, ho!
Medications that keep somebody alive, especially, should be made readily available and at a very, very low cost. We shouldn't be fighting for our lives.